Hey guys, it is Saturday morning and I'm catching some calls that I was unable to get yesterday. This one I believe is going to be a heat pump and I'm not real sure what the complaint is. I think they said there was something wrong with the return and something else. We're about to find out. It's working, but it's making a noise. Is that right?
It's really, really loud.
And there was something with the return.
Yeah, that thing won't latch.
It won't latch.
Yeah.
All right.
Gotta get that turned so it turns on.
Let me see here. So I'm gonna turn it up a little bit. He says it's really loud outside.
Yeah.
Like the fan is getting stuck. Okay. I'm gonna move this kayak, okay? Okay, what she's describing sounds like this fan is making a racket and then getting stuck. Just raining this morning. She said it's working fine, but while I'm here, so I'm going to watch this for a little while. That fan is turning freely. Maybe something else going on, like with the pressures. I bet that's what it is. Oh, that seems normal. Let's check pressures real quick. Let's see what if we got locking. Yep, we got locking valve caps. This has got one of my thermostats on the wall, so this could be an old installation of mine. Liquid line is hot. That liquid line should be warm, but not hot. Let's take a look at that filter and then the coil. I gotta go in that closet where they to go up here.
Okay.
So I'll be right back. First of all, that little return don't look like much. Two tons, so I don't need much. Let's look at the coil. Thank you. as y'all can see, that coil looks clean. About that. That's for the dryer. It don't look terribly kinked anywhere. It looks like a 12. All right, I think I'm gonna run it in cool for a little bit just to see what happens. All right, now we're running the air conditioning, so I'm gonna check on my superheat and subcool. Low subcooling. It's going up though. Okay. Those pressures seem normal. it's not dirty. That super heat is right here is coming down. Go get my jumpers real quick so I can run it in heat out here without changing it at the thermostat. I'm going to jump from red or yellow to blue. I just want to energize blue. We know yellow is energized. Excuse me guys, now I want to see if I have a difference between this pressure and that pressure over there. Suction is on my hot gas and liquid is on my liquid line. Watch that for just a second. The fact that we have low subcooling, 1.8, at temperatures like this, has me believing this is an airflow problem. That return is not ideal, but that should work. I'm gonna check on airspeed real quick, and while I'm doing it, I'm gonna run it in cool. The blue wire is on high on 5 and the green wire was on 1. I think the blue wire is the one that's energized. It's on high. Don't sound very high, but that's on high. Wide open. Wide open. All right, we're running it back in heat now. I still had a subcooling of 1.2. Last time I was out here was 3-4 months ago, and I cleaned the coil. And I just looked, the coil is still really clean. Remember, the suction is my head pressure. We got true readings running in heat. Those head pressures just seemed a little bit high. That's 400 is high. Alright guys, so I have recovered just a little bit, not much at all, and that pressure is closer to what I would expect. At these temperatures, I would think 315 or something. So I'm going to recover, I didn't recover much at all. Alright, we're running in cool. I don't know if y'all can see that, but those pressures do not look good. really low now. Well guys, after seeing that last little part of that video, I determined it most definitely was an airflow problem. And looking back at the sound of the blower when it was on high, it was not very high. So I have ordered a new blower motor just as an act of caution right here. And I'm probably gonna go back, replace the blower motor, and then see if our pressures do anything different. I don't think it had anything to do with the TXV or anything like that. I think it was an airflow problem. All the vents were open. So that's the plan, replace the motor. Thanks for watching, guys. Like and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll catch you on the next one.